unmute.
And if Tim needs to talk, I'll unmute. You're pretty close, Amy. Tim, Dr. Cody Kelly said to say hello.
Thank you.
Video
on. Oh, sorry. He's on.
Yeah, we can see you.
Thank you.
Hello, Jamie. Are you there?
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine. Can you read me? Can you hear me?
I can.
Okay, very good.
Such a
Hello.
Hi, Tim.
Hello.
I'm going to stand right to the front. Is it?
Oh,
Debbie left you.
Oh, gotcha. Oh, got it.
Was that your phone? You charge it?
Yeah.
Is that good?
There's no more.
I'm not sure how long.
I would have to go to voice.
That'll be the new workstations have chargers, UPS or UPS plugs. Need somebody that can do
Vegetables. Check this out.
What are you doing? You're trying to watch it.
There's not a peep.
Yeah, don't touch anything. Make sure you keep.
Yum. Yum.
You can't change that. Now you turned your fire speaker on.
The tortoise song.
We can now call this order. Will the deputy clerk please call the roll?
Legislators May.
Here.
Rowley.
Here.
Curtis.
Here.
Gwinnett.
Here.
Cody.
Here.
Abbott.
Here.
Hume.
Here.
Ryan.
Here.
Chase.
Here.
Olson.
Here.
McBride.
Here.
Knapp.
Here.
Bush.
Here.
Kelly.
Here.
Kinney.
Here.
Garland.
Here.
Urban.
Present.
17 present, 0 absent.
Legislator May will now give us the invocation followed by the salute to the flag by Legislator Rowley.
Dear Lord, thank you for the privilege to once again serve the residents of our great county. Thank you for your divine wisdom. Please guide us to excellence in our results and with conduct and performance featuring the utmost respect and consideration for everyone we serve and serve with. In your name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The first order of business is the election of the chair. Nominations are now in order. Legislators may raise their hands and provide a candidate's name. Thank you.
Federal, state, and local governments consist of three separate, independent, yet collaborative branches: executive, judicial, and legislative. We, as members of the legislative branch, are elected to represent the people by oversight of the budget and development of local laws. Choosing a leader for our legislative body, we need to look to a person with management experience, both in the public and the private sector. A person who takes the independence of the legislative body seriously, who will reach across the aisle to discuss and negotiate. Having an education with an MBA, a career including CFO of Onondaga County, supervisor of the town of Clay, budget officer for Cicero, and assistant superintendent of Oneida Schools, as well as two terms as legislator for District 2, it is my bipartisan honor to nominate Jim Rowley as our next chairperson.
Is there a second? Mr. Bush? Are there any further nominations? What's their name?
Thank you, Ryan. Rise to nominate Julie Abbott Keenan for chairperson. We've seen a lot of changes in this body over the years. Obviously, the past 2 years have been very, very difficult. I had the honor of serving during that time, but I think maybe the time has come to move on. And Julie has done yeoman's work on the health committee, leading that body. And I think she'll make an outstanding first woman ever to lead this legislature. And I wholeheartedly support her nomination.
Is there a second? Legislator Cummins? Are there any further nominations? Seeing none, nominations are now closed. The vote will be a long call. Each legislator will declare the name of the candidate of choice who has been duly nominated and seconded. Would that be clear, please call?
Legislator May?
Abbott.
Rowley.
Rowley.
Curtis.
Abbott.
Gwinnett.
Abbott.
Cody.
Abbott.
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 Hume.
Rowling.
Ryan.
Rowling.
Chase.
Rowling.
Olson.
Abbott.
McBride. Knapp.
Abbott.
Bush.
Rowling.
Kelly.
Abbott.
Kinney.
Rowling.
Garland.
Rowling.
Irvin.
Rowling.
Abbott 8, Rowling 9.
Legislator Rowley has been elected chair of the Ontario County Legislature. Will you please take your seat?
Maybe I know everyone's been here a long time, so I'd like to try to move this along as quickly as possible. I'm sorry.
All right, Chair.
Yeah. Okay. Just, I'm not the court. I'll stay here. I just want to maintain some distance at this point. Sorry. Okay. Yeah. So before we start, I just want to remind everyone, this is the organizational meeting of the county legislature. And as such, the chair drives this agenda. And at this point, I want to announce that I am pulling number 6 from the agenda. That will not be voted on tonight. Next, we have designation of floor leaders. So for the Republican floor leader, elected previously by the respective caucuses, that states the message that both designations have been filed with the clerk. Brian May is the Republican floor leader, and Chris Ryan is the Democratic floor leader. Also, I want to designate the official newspapers of the county legislature, and that would be the Post Standard as designated by both parties. Next, we have the election of clerk. Legislature may raise their hands and provide a candidate's name, and the nomination must be seconded. Is there a nomination?
Thank you. I nominate Jamie McNamara as clerk of the legislature. As we know, Jamie's been with us for quite some time and has done a fantastic job, particularly since taking over as clerk of the legislature, showing great leadership and decisiveness in her role, which obviously helps us all do a better job of what we do every day for the county. So I wholeheartedly support Jamie for clerk of the legislature. Thank you.
Is there a second? Legislator also. Okay. So before taking the vote, are there any further nominations for clerk? Seeing none, nominations are now closed. Each legislator will vote one call vote, and each legislator should declare the name of the candidate of choice. We've been duly nominated and second, and we only have one candidate, so please call.
Legislators May.
McNamara.
Ryan.
McNamara.
Burtis.
McNamara.
Winup.
McNamara.
Cody.
McNamara.
Abbott.
McNamara.
Hume.
McNamara.
Chase.
McNamara.
Olson.
McNamara.
McBride.
McNamara.
Knapp.
McNamara.
Bush.
McNamara.
Kelly.
McNamara.
Kinney.
McNamara.
Garland.
McNamara.
Irvin.
McNamara.
Mr. Chairman.
McNamara.
17 for McNamara.
Okay, the next order of business is the election of the deputy clerk. I'm sorry, to the clerk, please take their seat. Next order of business is the election of the deputy clerk. Nominations are now in order. Questions, you can raise your hand and nominate someone for the deputy clerk. Is there a nomination? Legislator Olson.
Yes, I'd like to nominate Melanie Villardi for this position. Thank you for your consideration.
Is there a second? Legislator, are other nominations? Seeing none, the nominations are now closed. We cast by a long call. And again, each legislator needs to declare a new campaign of their choice. They've been duly nominated and set. Clerk, please call the long call.
Legislators May.
Velarde.
Ryan.
Velarde.
Curtis.
Velarde.
Gunnett.
Velarde.
Cody.
Velarde.
Abbott.
Velarde.
Kuhn.
Velarde.
Chase.
Velarde.
Olson.
Velarde.
McBride.
Velarde.
Knapp.
Velarde.
Bush.
Velarde.
Kelly.
Velarde.
Kinney.
Velarde.
Garland.
Velarde.
Irvin.
Velarde.
Mr. Chairman.
Velarde.
17 for Velarde.
Okay. And the clerk has been duly elected and she got the winner's seat. Next we have, election of the assistant clerk. Is there a nomination for assistant clerk?
I, as serving in the assistant clerk position back in 2004, I'm honored to nominate Deborah Kaminsky for that position.
Is there a second? Legislator King. Are there any further nominations? Seeing none, nominations are called. Vote will be a long call again, and I ask that each legislator please state the last name of their choice for assistant clerk.
Legislators May.
Kaminsky.
Ryan.
Kaminsky.
Curtis.
Kaminsky.
Gunnett.
Kaminsky.
Cody.
Kaminsky.
Abbott.
Kaminsky.
Kuhn.
Kaminsky.
Chase.
Kaminsky.
Olson.
Kaminsky.
McBride.
Kaminsky.
Knapp.
Kaminsky.
Bush.
Kaminsky.
Kelly.
Kaminsky.
Kinney.
Kaminsky.
Garland.
Kaminsky.
Irvin?
Kaminsky.
Mr. Chairman?
Kaminsky.
17 for Kaminsky.
Okay, Debbie Kaminsky has been duly elected assistant clerk of the county legislature. Next, will that be clerk, please read the title of the follow-up of the next resolution, number 4.
Confirming appointment of Darcy L. Lesniak as Director of Legislative Budget Review of the Onondaga County Legislature.
Is there any discussion? Chairman,
thank you. I have the great pleasure of nominating advancing Darcy Lesniak on your behalf as our legislative budget director of legislative budget review. Darcy rose into this role 2 years ago, three years ago, and has done a fantastic job for serving everyone on the legislature ever since. And the work product and results get better every day through Darcy's performance. I look forward to another 2 years with Darcy in this role, and I wholeheartedly urge adoption of this resolution. Thank you.
Any other discussion? Seeing none, clerk will call a short call. Or call a long call, I'm sorry.
Legislators May?
Yes.
Curtis. Curtis.
Lesniak.
Gunnett.
Lesniak.
Cody.
Lesniak.
Abbott.
Lesniak.
Kuhn.
Lesniak.
Chase.
Lesniak.
Olson.
Lesniak.
McBride.
Lesniak.
Knapp.
Yes.
Bush.
Lesniak.
Kelly?
Lesniak.
Kinney?
Lesniak.
Garland?
Lesniak.
Irvin?
Lesniak.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
17 ayes, none opposed.
Motion is carried.
Confirming appointment of Ryan P. Francis as legislative analyst of the Onondaga County Legislature.
Is there any discussion?
Thank you, Chairman. I rise and support of the appointment of Ryan Francis to the legislative analyst position here in the legislature. Ryan has been with us for a little bit, and he has proven a almost every day. His skills, abilities, and willingness to help us all increase, and I urge his adoption to this resolution. Thank you.
Any other discussion? Leader Ryan.
Just a brief discussion I have, which is not on the agenda. I have two additional items that I'll be asking a waiver for. That obviously this is a vacated position that perhaps we do not fill at this time until we can take a look and see if we need both the legislative analyst and legislative aid. So I would just I won't be voting for this confirmation at this point in time, but not about the individual per se, but because of the position.
Is there any other discussion? Clerk will call the roll, please.
Legislators May?
Yes.
Ryan?
No.
Furtis?
Francis?
Gunnett?
Francis.
Cody?
Yes.
Abbott?
Yes.
Kuhn?
No.
Chase?
No.
Olson?
Yes.
McBride?
Yes.
Knapp?
Yes.
Bush?
Yes.
Kelly?
Yes.
Kinney?
No.
Garland?
No.
Urban?
No.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
11 ayes, 6 opposed.
Motion's pending. Next, we have a meeting of minutes. There are motion to waive the reading.
So moved.
So moved. Any objection? Meeting of minutes is waived. Approval of the minutes. So we have a motion to approve the minutes.
Moved.
So moved. Any objection? Minutes. Minutes are approved. Any communications?
None.
Did anyone sign up for the public comment period?
None have signed up.
Is there anyone here that should make a comment at this point in time on this agenda? Seeing none, public comment period is closed. Reports of standing committees?
None.
Reports of special committees?
None.
And since number 12 is waived, number 6 is waived, will has been pulled, will waive the call of the legislative districts. Is there any unfinished business? Yeah, Ryan, did you want to bring something up?
I did. I want to call the district. I want to have an addition. I believe I have a resolution of confirmation of appointment of John and Sanis as a legislative.
Does the clerk have a resolution?
Yes.
Can you ask yourself, please? So I'm going to get legal. I'm going to question that waiver is not required. Okay. Please read the resolution.
Confirming appointment of John N. DeSantis as legislative aide of the Onondaga County Legislature.
Is there a motion? You move. Is there a second? Legislator Urban, discussion.
Yes, so I just want to add a historical perspective here. We have, the Democratic Caucus. Let's say before John Sanis, Scott Butler, was our very own illustrious William Kinney. Before Bill Kinney was a gentleman by the name of John Corcoran. Before John Corcoran was a gentleman by the name of Bob Sprague. And this goes back to 1998, and that was, as my understanding, it was a 12-12 split. 24 legislators, 12 Democrats, 12 Republicans. And part of what came out of that was a legislative aide that worked for the Democratic caucus. Since then, 23 years ago, nearly a quarter of a century, that name, that person, that individual who worked for the Democratic caucus. And I'm sure that through the years, there were some, perhaps some Republican members who either were not satisfied with that name, but nonetheless, that person was appointed. This will be the first time since 1998 that the Democratic caucus put forth a name for the Democratic caucus legislative aide. As we all know, everything that we do down here, there's a lot of work that goes behind the scenes. There's a lot of work that entails. There's a lot of work for, especially around budget time. There's things that we need to do, talk to, work on our behalf to advance our laws, our ideas, our budget resolutions. That's always a person that, as expense point to me, we all think, going back to the years, 23 years ago, that was somebody that we need, we can believe. So with that said, and then fast forward this year, it seems to be that dynamic has changed a little bit, but here's what I'm not going to do. I'm not going to get into any of that. All I'm saying is that historically speaking, the Democratic caucus has needed somebody that they can confide in and that they're comfortable with. We're certainly more than comfortable with John. We advocate for him, and we very much like some support on our side. Now, I don't think we have a number of other legislators. I know that everybody says that they work for the county, and they work here, but we have just one person. I'm just respectfully requesting some consideration and some support for the individual that has worked on our behalf for the past 2 years. We have faith in, we trust, very much would like for us to consider. Continue with this. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other discussion? Seeing none, clerk will call Long.
Legislator Demme?
No.
Ryan?
Yes.
Burtis?
No.
Dunnett?
No.
Cody?
No.
Abbott?
No.
Kuhn?
Yes.
Chase?
Yes.
Olson?
No.
McBride?
No.
Knapp?
No.
Bush?
Yes.
Kelly?
No.
Kinney?
Yes.
Garland?
Yes.
Irvin?
Yes.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
8 ayes, 9 opposed.
Motion is defeated. Is there any other unfinished business? Seeing none, I would like to just make a few comments and then make an adjournment. So no announcements, but just a few comments. Again, first of all, I want to thank Chairman Knapp for his leadership over the past 5 years. He has certainly guided his body through some big issues, and I'm personally grateful for his leadership. Next, I want to thank the majority of legislators and board for me. I'm honored to serve, and I will do my utmost to validate your trust in me. To the rest of my colleagues, I will work hard to earn your trust during this coming term, and I can make a promise of that. As chairman, please know that I will not take marching orders from the county executive or the Republican Party. I will only take marching orders from this body. I work for all of you, regardless of party affiliation. The legislature is a co-equal, independent branch of county government, a crucial check on the county executive. And while the county executive can propose, it is our duty to dispose, and we will do so on our terms and our timeline. We control the power of the purse. We are the only body that can adopt a budget, appropriate funds, create or abolish positions, as well as fund them. Only we can adopt changes to the charter and code. We have much power as a legislative body, and we should exercise this power with fidelity and care. That all being said, I am a Republican, and I intend to caucus with my fellow Republicans, I hope. We will disagree philosophically, but as we disagree, we need to be fair to each other and treat each other with respect. Just remember that although we do important work here, it is not more important than faith, family, or health. It just can never be. I would be remiss if I did not mention the surge in COVID our county is experiencing. Let us hope it gets better before it gets much worse, and let us work together to make sure our county executive and our employees have the resources they need to deal with it. And again, I thank you for the trust you've placed in me, and I wish you all a happy and healthy new year. Is there a motion to adjourn?
I move to adjourn until Tuesday, February 1st.
Thank you.